Hi guys, today I'm gonna show you how to fix if the brake lights don't work anymore. There is a small resistor in the assembly that makes the brake lights blink, and it's an SMD part, and it seems it's a little bit too weak, so it burns through. And yeah, the first thing is you don't have to open the deck. I just did this beforehand because I'm doing some more things now. You just have to unscrew the front plastic plate. There are from the downside there are two cross screws. Yeah, you have to lose them, and then as it is really, really cramped and less space inside of the main part of the deck here, most of the things, the cables that don't necessarily fit here, are just here in the side. They are here back there. And what we need is the part that's here in this green shrink wrap. You can see it. It comes from a connector that is orange and white from the controller. You unplug it here. So, and it has the two. These are both the same. Yeah, the two green yellow connectors that go to the middle part of the rear lights. Because the rear lights have both the normal light that's here, the red and black, and green yellow is the actual brake light that blinks. Yeah, so I'm gonna disconnect that. So there are two options now. One is you just connect these pieces here together, and connected with this yellow white part. What would happen then is that the brake light just lights up if you hit the brakes. There is a reason that this is not done up front, and I can show you that, because if I connect one of these, I'll do that. Wait, so it's hard to do that with one hand. Yep, come on. Yep, got it. So if I connect these and turn the lights on the scooter, do this now, and I hit the brake, you see there is a difference, but it's really small. It's too small to actually be seen really good. So it's better to fix this part here. I'm gonna do that now. First, you cut open this shrink tube. You can do this with a scissor, with other small tools that fit. Yeah, I usually do it like this, and I always cut open a small part only. Until I am through, I'm going to do this now. The best idea is to use the side, the middle of the side here, yeah, where you can see this flat space, and not these two pieces that stand out. I'm gonna show you later on why. So I cut it open. I can take this part out now. And the thing is, if you cut open the other side, you're gonna destroy these two connections probably. What I'm going to do next is remove this. Sorry. This resistor here, the small one that says 101. It's a 100 ohm resistor, And if the thing is broken, the brake light is broken, usually this resistor dies. So you can take a multimeter, measure it, and if it doesn't show the 100 ohms it should, you can replace the resistor. I have here some resistors up front, yeah, so 100 ohm batch, and I'm going to use one of them, cut one of them out. Already did, as you see, there's one missing. I'm gonna use the next one, bend it and show it to you how this is replaced. Next is to unsolder this thing. This is, in this case, it's pretty easy because you can't really damage this part anymore. It's already broken. Yeah, so just heat it up and let go. Your small thing. Next is put some solder on the feet of this resistor, and then solder it here. I can't really show this because I only have two hands and I need both of them for the soldering. And if you're not confident with soldering, just find someone who can and ask him to help you. So afterwards it should look something like this. I've bent it upwards a little so that it doesn't stick out that much, the resistor. But you should be fine anyway, so there's not really a reason. Just solder it anyway and look that the connections don't touch something else, and yeah, should be fine. So next is I'm going to repack this in this shrink wrap, and I don't have a fitting size shrink wrap, and the easiest thing is to just put it in again, take some duct tape and just fix it and put it in again into the scooter. This will be a little bit of not that easy, as there's always very little space and you have to push all the things and the cables back in where you think they were. Duct tape. So I connected it again, and the best thing you should do now is to just test if it really works and not push everything in and then see that the fix didn't even help. Yeah, so I